Being a tree ain't easy. Dogs pee on them. People cut them down for raw materials to make everything from toilet paper to million-dollar homes, and those that dare to defend them are called tree huggers, a moniker that makes it difficult for most people to take their cause seriously. But the simple truth is that we should all do what we can to promote tree conservation, because every animal on the planet depends on them. In this episode of Animal Facts, we'll focus on the relationship between animals and trees, a mutually beneficial relationship that is vital to the life cycle of both.
You're watching Animal Facts.
The Team Trees initiative, started by YouTuber Mr. Beast, has a goal of putting 20 million trees in the ground around the globe by January 2020. All proceeds go to the Arbour Day Foundation, that promises to plant a tree for every dollar donated. Check it out, there's a link below this video. Trees are essential to the continuity of all species. Well, for starters, they produce the element that we all need to survive, oxygen. But there are so many other ways that trees are essential to the survival of wildlife. The life cycle of a tree consists of 7 stages: seed, sprout, seedling, sapling, mature, decline, and snag. Each stage, either directly or indirectly, provides one or more basic needs of our animal friends. Forest animals such as birds, squirrels, deer, and bears rely on nuts or seeds like acorns for food. In the process of foraging for seeds, some of them get stuck to their feathers and fur, hitching a ride to other areas where the seeds sprout up into new trees, furthering the growth diversity of the area. And sometimes our furry friends forget where they bury their snack stash, and before you know it, there's a new sprout in the neighborhood. It's a win for the animals and the trees. Sprouts and seedlings provide valuable nutrients for small creatures, many of whom are herbivorous and depend solely on plant material for food. The sprout and seedling stages are also the most critical periods in the life cycle of a tree. Like babies of any other life form, baby trees need to be fed regularly. Trees make their own food through photosynthesis, a process which requires sufficient amounts of water, sunlight, and carbon dioxide from the air. If a baby tree gets too much or too little of these elements, its delicate internal balance will be upset and it will die. But its death will not be in vain. The remains will decompose and help fertilize the soil, so other plants and trees will have a better chance to mature and thrive. Once trees reach maturity, they are invaluable to the wildlife that surrounds them. Like humans, animals prefer to live in areas where they have access to everyday conveniences. So what better place for an animal to set up camp than a strong, healthy tree? Not only do trees provide shelter, strong limbs for resting and nesting, and lookout posts for hunting prey, they also supply the most precious commodity of all, food. Most tree dwellers survive on the fruits, nuts, or leaves that their trees produce. It's like owning a farm or house with a garden on back. Can't get more convenient than that. Any sensible landlord collects rent from tenants, and trees are no different. For all that the trees offer them, the animals help the trees in very important ways: pollination, propagation, and fertilization. Plants and trees create new seeds through pollination. As hummingbirds or insects like bees and butterflies travel from flower to flower, sucking their nectar, pollen from the flower stamen cling to them, and when they touch another plant's stigma, the pollen is deposited and a new seed begins to form. Seeds are introduced into new territory through propagation. Propagation occurs when animals eat a tree's fruit, digest it, and defecate in another location, leaving the seeds behind to grow into new seeds, or when seeds get stuck to or tangled in animals' fur and fall off elsewhere. Perhaps the most precious commodity that an animal can offer a tree is poop. Yes, poop. When used as a fertilizer, animal manure is a rich source of nutrients, organic matter, and microbes. These nutrients are building blocks that are essential to the tree's growth, and the microbes are nature's hazmat crew, helping to rid the soil of contaminants. Poop as a decontaminant. Ironic, don't you think? Even snags, or standing trees that are dead or dying, play an important part in sustaining wildlife. Birds and other animals claim snags as storage units or use them for roosting, nesting, and perching. Mature trees with attributes similar to dying trees, like hollowed out trunks, cavities, or dead branches, can also prove valuable to animals in surrounding areas. In addition, snags can add to the biodiversity of an area by attracting wildlife that wouldn't normally be found there. Also, snags that are rooted near rivers or streams may fall into the water, enhancing the aquatic habitat and supplying wildlife like ducks, frogs, and alligators with wood for perching, shelter, and nesting. Now it's time we break it all down, literally. Although decaying logs and dead wood are part of the final stage of a tree's life cycle, it doesn't mean these remains aren't as valuable as they once were. They just serve a new purpose for a different set of creatures. The nutrients and moisture of decaying logs encourage new plant growth and provide the perfect habitat for earthworms and many insects, like beetles. Wood from dead trees is also naturally repurposed as ground cover, which helps curb soil erosion and keeps wildlife such as deer from plundering plant seedlings. Finally, as bacteria, fungi, and insects break down the wood, it becomes softer and softer until it decomposes completely and returns to the earth. Yep, the symbiotic relationship between trees and animals is so tightly woven that without it, life as we know it would cease to exist. And although being a tree ain't easy, they make life considerably easy for us. So next time you go hiking or take a walk in the park, branch out and hug a tree. They deserve it. If you like this video, you're sure to like these. If you're a subscriber, thank you. If not, what are you waiting for? Thanks for hanging with me. And as always, catch you next time.